आई एम गणेश बी आगलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर वील सी द यूनिट कंडक्शन इन दैट जनरल हीट कंडक्शन इक्वेशन इन कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम. लर्निंग आउटकम: एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिराइव जनरल हीट कंडक्शन इक्वेशन इन कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम. Now, consider this as an element of the system. Small part, maybe rectangular or square, is taken of a big system, which is exposed to the heat transfer. Now, here the surface A, B, C, D. Through this face, Qx amount of heat is flowing in the x direction, and the thickness in the x direction from the origin x is a dx. The face A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash is losing the Qx plus dx amount of heat, that is in the x direction. Now remaining two surfaces are also exposed to the heat transfer. So, in the y direction, Qy amount of heat enters through the bottom surface, and the thickness in the y direction is dy. It flows, it conducts throughout this element, and from the top surface, it is losing Qy plus dy. Remember, this surface is exposed to the heat transfer in the conductive mode. So can you think for the z direction also? Yes. Qz amount of heat is entering from the back side, okay, and its thickness in the z direction is dz. Then this front surface will lose Qz plus dz amount of heat. So this was the Cartesian coordinate system in which we have shown the small element of the big system. Now we'll try to see the different equations respectively in x direction, y direction, and in the z direction. Here we'll be using the energy balance equation, because what is going to happen whenever there is a heat transfer, the temperature gradient must be present, that is low temperature and high temperature. Heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature. Because of that, there may be some possibility of internal heat generation, which will be denoted by small qg. And at the same time, there might be internal rise in the temperature of the element. Okay, now we'll go through the next step. So here, the qx heat is entering into this surface, which has the equation, that is Fourier's law of heat conduction, we can apply. So Qx is equal to minus k dou t by dou x dy dz. Here we are going to consider all the three dimensions, and for this equation we have considered only conductive heat in x axis. So this was for the surface ABCD. Now from the opposite surface A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, the equation becomes dqx plus dx is equal to dqx plus dou by dou x of dqx dx. This is the Taylor's expansion. Now, this can be simplified. We can substitute dqx as minus k over here, minus is taken common, dou t by dou x plus dou by dou x as it is we have written here. Then what is the dqx? It is k, minus is taken common. So k dou t by dou x into dx, and remaining two axes will be dy dz. Here dx dy dz is nothing but the volume of the element. So this equation, these three equations we have seen along the x axis. Now we will consider the y axis. Through the y axis, dqy amount of heat is entering, and this top surface is leaving Qy plus dy amount of heat. So similarly, I can write for the y-axis also dqy is equal to minus k dou t by dou y dx dz. And through the top surface, which is losing the heat, is dqy plus dy is equal to minus is taken common. So what is qy? It is minus k dou t by dou y plus dou by dou y, as it is written here in the bracket, k dou t by dou y bracket complete dy bracket complete dx dz. This was y axis. Now in the z axis, similarly, dqz is equal to minus k dou t by dou z dx dy, and Taylor's expansion is used for dqz plus dz as minus k dou t by dou z plus dou by dou z k dou t by dou z bracket complete dz dx dy. So this is regarding three equations. We can write these three equations for three different axes in the Cartesian coordinate system. This assume it as a first one. Then the equation can be simplified for the net amount of heat conducted. Net amount of heat conducted means dqx minus dqx plus dx plus dqy minus dqy plus dy plus dqz minus dqz plus dz. So that step is omitted over here, and directly we have written dqx plus dqy plus dqz minus in another bracket dqx plus dx plus dqy plus dy plus dqz plus dz. And we can get now, see here, we can get here dou by dou x in the bracket k dou t by dou x. Now what is going to happen here? We can write it also k dou square t by dou x square plus k dou square t by dou y square plus k dou square t by dou z square. So all the three dimensions we have considered, three axes we have considered over here, and this is the volume dx dy dz. Now this was regarding net amount of heat conducted. Okay, now here we'll consider the second part, that is the possibility of internal heat generation inside the element. So the internal heat generation will be equal to q dx q bar dx dy dz, and the rate of change of internal energy will be equal to mcp delta t. Now rho is equal to mass per unit volume, so m could be replaced by rho into v. So what is v here? Dx dy dz. So this equation becomes rho cp dou t by dou t. This is the change in temperature over time, dx dy dz. So if we apply the energy balance equation, that is net heat conducted plus internal heat generation is equal to change in internal energy of the system, the equation can be written as dou by dou x of k dou t by dou x plus dou by dou y k dou t by dou y axis plus dou by dou z k dou t by dou z axis plus internal heat generation is equal to rho cp dou t by dou t. This is known as generalized heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate system. Now if the case is that there is no internal heat generation, you can omit this. And for steady state condition, change in temperature over the time will be zero. So in that case, for three dimensional heat flow without heat generation, for steady state condition, the equation will become equal to zero. In that case, Q will be zero and this change in temperature will be zero because it is a steady state condition. We'll try to see it. Now, for a homogeneous material in this here, we'll be assuming the conductivity in x direction, y direction and z direction is the same, that is kx is equal to ky is equal to kz is equal to k, then k I can take common, k in the bracket dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q is equal to rho cp dt by dt. Now here del operator we will consider. So this is nothing but del square t plus q by k. This will be dividing both sides by k. So del square t plus q by k is equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t, where del square is equal to this one. Now here alpha is nothing but thermal diffusivity, which is a ratio of k by rho cp. For highly conductive material, the thermal diffusivity will be higher, and for lower thermal conductivity material like insulators, the thermal diffusivity will be small. So the unit of the thermal diffusivity is meter square per second. Now just now we have written del square t is equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. This is for steady state condition. We can write this equation for steady state condition, that is del square t is equal to 0. This will be general heat conduction equations Laplace transform without heat generation and for steady state condition. In this fashion you can use for single dimension, two dimensions, etc., etc., the general heat conduction equation. For further study you can refer Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Inkropera David. Thank you.